Welcome to Savitha Dental College lecture cast on prosthodontics, jaw relations part 5, vertical relation. So vertical jaw relation has two measurements, vertical dimension at rest and vertical dimension at occlusion. Always when at rest, there will be a space between the teeth. This is around 2 to 3 millimeters and it's called freeway space. So rest can be recorded, or the vertical dimension at rest can be recorded with the help of pre-extraction records. There are three pre-extraction records we can use: pre-extraction radiographs, pre-extraction photographs, and pre-extraction models. The next most popular method is the Niswonger and Thompson's method, where you ask the patient to say MMMMM, and you mark a point in the nose and the chin, and you determine the distance, and that will be a vertical dimension at rest. Profile sellouts is cutting a cardboard outline and exactly to the patient's face, and asking the patient to relax and then bite, so that you know how much freeway space is reduced. And then the next method is using ridge relation. So if you can part between the lips and see that the ridges are parallel to each other, your vertical dimension is around the right area. Next is vertical dimension at occlusion. Vertical dimension at occlusion can be calculated with the help of the Boost bimeter. It is basically a central bearing device, which means there are two plates, one attached to each occlusal rim, and there's a pin in between. This pin is a pressure sensitive pin, and the patient has to bite with the maximum force possible. And the pin's height is changed to various dimensions and the bite force is measured. The point at which there is a maximum bite force, it's called the power point, and that will be the vertical dimension at occlusion. Phonetics, you can use two methods to again determine your vertical dimension, that is Pound and Murrell's technique and Silverman's closest speaking space. In Silverman's closest speaking space, we use the ask the patient to say 61, 62, 63, like that, all the variables of letter S. And that is the time at which the jaw is very close to each other, and that will give you a vertical dimension at occlusion. And phonetics with Pound and Murrell's method is asking the patient to say F, V, and S. When you notice, when you say these letters, usually the upper teeth will touch the lower lip, and that will give you optimal VD. And if you have your mouth open and saying F, you will see that it will sound wrong. And the next is tactile perception, which is similar to Boost bimeter, except that it is not a pressure sensitive pin. And the patient just reports that whichever height between the two central bearing plates, whichever height is comfortable, that is a vertical dimension at occlusion. And this is very important to have an ideal vertical dimension. If there's too much vertical dimension, the patient is going to look long-faced, ugly, and generally there will be more resorption because of more force and stretching of the muscles, having a poor cheek support, etc. Whereas if there's too less of vertical dimension, you may get angular chelitis and a very collapsed looking, again a very ugly looking appearance, and so on. So an optimal VD is necessary to have optimal aesthetics and a very good prosthetic outcome. Thank you.